All of us scientists, we don't take advantage of automation as much as we could. So in my lab, we've been thinking a lot about how robotics and artificial intelligence can combine with chemistry to create something that we like to call self-driving laboratories. Basically, a laboratory where as much as possible, the mundane decisions of what the next experiment to be done next or the next conditions to try are actually optimized using artificial intelligence. And therefore, we don't waste reagents, we don't waste time, and we don't waste all the resources that will make science progress slower. When I moved to Canada, we started building a such self-driving laboratory for developing thin films. And you might say, well, why are thin films so important? Well, it turns out that almost every energy technology involves a thin film, say a solar cell or a battery, that have these materials laid out in a very thin layer. So what we built, a machine that is actually manufacturing and testing thin films with different conditions to try to optimize their performance. So that's an example of one of the things that we're doing concretely to try to accelerate innovation. Within 5 years, I would like my lab and my collaborators around the world to be able to demonstrate that these self-driving laboratories not only are successful, but that actually have a positive change in the energy ecosystem. Maybe some laboratory that used our technology based off Taiwan was able to come up with a better way of filtering water. Or another laboratory based off Mexico was able to find a better molecule for energy generation. So in some sense, we would like to create a virus where people are actually now automating their laboratories for rapid discovery.